a good day for it anyway. It's a good day for just about anything, if you can believe the weather bureau, that is. I think it's not making a claim up there. They can make way for new stars. They're giving us what they've been left to be offered. E.g.
Morning, Mr. Shields.
Good night, Tony. They tell me you got a big match on Saturday.
Yeah, if we win this, we're in the finals.
Well, good luck to you, son.
Thanks.
And snow in the desert by the weekend. But here's the important bit, or the only part of it you can believe. It's 7 degrees now. And you'll have to take my word for that.
What's wrong? I like you.
Mike Tracy.
Turn it off.
Listen, the government has released a new bunch of vital statistics.
Nobody moves. Nobody gets hurt.
Okay. Everyone down on the ground. Quick.
Please, can I get outside? Look, I don't feel very well.
Show her out, mate.
Okay. This way, lady.
Thank you.
Put it down.
Can't you read?
Eh?
You're parked in a no-standing zone. You've got to move.
Oh, yeah, look, the missus is just doing a bit of shopping, mate. She'll be back in a minute. Well, there's nowhere else to park, is there? Look, if I see a space, I'll move, okay?
I'll give you 5 minutes.
Who's got the other key?
There's only one. Mr. Taylor's got it.
Who's his assistant? Open.
No, I can't. I don't know how.
Okay, down on the floor. Down on the floor.
I told you to move on.
There's nowhere else to park, is there?
Look, I'm just doing my job. Move.
Just give us a ticket and piss off, will you?
Oh, yeah, that's the way you want it, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that's the way I want it, mate. Jesus Christ.
Hey,
Now, if he moves, kill him.
Can I see your license, please, driver? Okay, come on, get out.
Jesus, mate. Hold it!
Step in. Right in. Press 15. Press 15.
Keys in the car.
That's a silly thing to do. Why didn't you call the NRMA?
I'm not a member.
How's your general health?
Okay.
When was the last time you had a full checkup?
Not since I was a kid.
You should have them more regularly, you know. You're not getting any younger.
None of us are.
Thank you.
Who's your regular doctor, Mr. Shields?
I haven't got one up here. I come from Melbourne.
And when was the last time you saw him?
Oh, quite a while back.
Mm-hmm. Well, we've had a look at your x-rays and the results from your bone marrow and blood tests.
And?
And, I'm afraid we've found evidence of cancer. It started in your lungs.
What are my chances?
I'm afraid your blood has carried it throughout your body. Now, if we hospitalize you...
No. No.
I'm not going to lie to you, Peter. In a couple of weeks, you'll have no choice. You'll have to go into hospital. And until then, you're going to need somebody to look after you. You married? Do you have any relatives here in Sydney?
No. No one.
Maybe I could help.
Thanks. But I can look after myself.
Mr. Shields?
Holidays, mate.
What for?
Me health. You heard of the birds that fly south? Well, that's me.
How long are you going for?
I don't know. Could be quite a while, Cobber.
You want me to keep an eye on your room for you?
Thanks.
See you, Mr. Shields.
Goodbye, Tony.
You.
I haven't changed that much, have I?
You look just the same.
So do you.
I feel older. Much older.
Not through these eyes.
I've missed you.
How's Bryan? Last I heard, he was a bricky's labourer.
Yeah, that lasted about 6 months.
What happened?
He was victimised.
Did that bastard Anderson have anything to do with it?
Yeah. Tried to get Bryan for a warehouse break-in. We couldn't afford the bail, so he ended up in remand for a week.
Why didn't you tell me?
We didn't know where you were. No one did.
Which one is she?
Can't you tell?
I'll say the kid in red. She looks as pretty as her mum.
Kathy? Time to go home. G'day, Kathy. This is your uncle.
Hello.
G'day, Kathy. Call me Pete. How's school?
Good.
You know, that Brian's a lucky bloke.
Try telling him that. He thinks she looks like you.
Jesus Christ, miracles do happen.
How are you, Brian?
All right. No, I'm not all right. I'm pissed off. Should never have gone straight.
What's wrong?
Ah, smashed up one of the cars. I ran in the back of a Valiant. Bastard couldn't even speak English. Wog. Probably won his license in a raffle.
You haven't changed.
What are you doing down here? I mean, we don't see you for 5 years, and the next minute you're on our doorstep. You're up to something, aren't you?
Could be. Or I might have just come down here to visit some friends.
Friends? You don't have any friends. All your friends are in the fucking nick.
It's nice language to use in front of your daughter.
Since when have you become so bloody respectable?
Just watch yourself, Brian.
What's for dinner?
Steak and kidney pie.
Great, I'm starving. How long you plan to stay for?
I don't know. It all depends.
Long enough for us to do a couple of jobs? Relive our youth?
Yeah, I thought we might knock over a warehouse together. You might as well. You've already done a week in remand for it.
Fucking Anderson. Couldn't get use on the next best thing. Had it in for me ever since you went to Sydney. Lost my job because of the cunt.
Brian?
Perhaps I shouldn't have come down here. I seem to have a bad effect on him.
Don't be stupid. It's great to see you.
Come on, you two. It's nearly ready.
Where are you staying?
Haven't given any thought to it.
Well, you may as well stay here tonight.
Yeah, I'll make up the couch.
Who's that for? Pete or me? What's wrong? Said, what's wrong?
It's a pretty stupid thing to say.
It's only a joke.
Was it?
Is Curtis still organizing things?
Yeah, and Jack solicits for him.
What? Jack's working for Curtis too?
Yeah, I'm telling you, things aren't the same anymore. I mean, you can't just roll up and get a job. Curtis wants you, he'll find you.
He'll find me, all right.
Come off it, Pete.
Things don't work like that anymore. There's no room for loners.
That's what you know.
Listen, Pete, how old are you now?
You know how old I am. 44.
And what do you got to show for it?
That's my life.
Oh, fuck.
I'm doing one last job.
Don't fucking lie to me. Shit, I'm glad I stopped when I did.
You stopped because I left.
Bullshit. I got responsibility, something you'd know nothing about. Why don't you go back to Sydney? The weather's better there.
I'll see you, Bryan. There's a funny smell in this bar. I think it's you, Anderson.
What are you doing here, Shields? Things get too hot for you up north.
Believe it or not, I just came down to see you. They tell me you're making life difficult for me little brother.
Not half as difficult as it's going to get unless you piss off out of here.
I'm going. You're going to come outside with me.
Look, just get out of here. You're not wanted.
You're gutless, Anderson. You were when you were a pig. You're worse now you're working for Curtis.
You'll never learn, will you? Okay, you want it, you've got it.
You'll regret this, Shields. One of these days, I'm going to put a hole right through your back.
Yeah?
Phone for you.
Who is it?
They wouldn't say.
Just a moment.
Gotcha!
I won't be long. Don't you let her beat you.
Hello? Mr. Curtis. It's Jack here. What the hell do you want? I'm sorry to trouble you at home, Mr. Curtis, but something's happened.
It'll keep till Monday.
But I thought you might like to know. Anderson's been worked over. Nice job, too.
That's no concern of mine.
I'm afraid it is, Mr. Curtis. You see, Anderson was going to drive for us on Tuesday night.
Well, you'll just have to find someone else, won't you?
That's easier said than done. Anderson's been in on this from the beginning.
All right, all right. Just get off the line, will you? We'll sort it out on Monday.
Okay. Whatever you say, Mr. Curtis.
What brought you down here?
You haven't got too many friends left, you know.
I'm looking for work.
Yeah?
That's why I came to see you. They tell me you're pulling jobs for Curtis.
Curtis wouldn't have a bar of you now. You're a lone wolf.
What about me little brother?
Bryan?
Yeah. You got anything for him?
Depends. What's he good at?
Driving.
Small world, isn't it? We need someone this week. I'll give Bryan a ring tonight.
Thanks, Jack.
Pleasure. Have you got anything on?
Maybe.
Like to tell me about it?
No.
Haven't changed much, have you?
You have. Working for Curtis.
I'm getting old and can't afford to take risks anymore. I've got three kids to think about.
Yeah. What's the job?
Pete, you know I can't tell you that.
Suit yourself.
It's nothing out of the ordinary. Just one of Curtis's own warehouses. A whole range of imported colour TVs. Fitchett's worth about 400, but insured for twice that amount. Beautiful, eh?
Yeah. When's all this going to happen?
Tuesday night.
You could have told me you were moving out.
I left you a note.
Last time you left a note, I didn't see you for 5 years.
Well, I'm here now, aren't I?
Did Bryan ask you to leave?
He might have.
Jesus Christ, what is it with you two? Well, he's not a kid anymore. You don't owe him a thing. My feelings you should care about, not his.
Jeannie's me brother.
When you wipe his bloody nose for him, he's lost another job.
What happened?
Someone told his boss he had a record.
Is that right? Jesus, there's some bastards around. Still, a young fellow like Bryan shouldn't have any trouble finding a job.
Let's hope so. He's out seeing someone this afternoon.
Well, if he doesn't get it, he can always come back and work with me.
I suppose that's the reason you came back to Melbourne.
Is that what you think?
No. Let's just walk.
You are up to something, aren't you, you bastard?
I didn't hear you knock, mate.
Cut that shit. What are you doing down here in Melbourne?
I told you. I'm on holidays.
Yeah, then why'd you get me fired? And don't say you didn't, because I found out. Why the fuck would you want to do that to your own brother? And then you line me up to work for Curtis. What's your fucking game? And why am I always the last one to find out? Can't I ever trust you? And don't think I don't know about you and Jeannie 5 years ago either.
Is that what's bothering you? Well, because I left, you had to go straight.
Oh, don't kid yourself, mate. I had the guts to stick around, you pissed off. Jesus Christ, I don't even know if my kid's my own because of you.
Then why did you stay?
Because she's Jeannie's child and Jeannie's my wife.
That's right.
Well, I want to know. Is Kathy your kid?
What difference does it make?
Well, I get fucked. Why didn't you just stay away?
Not if you don't. Now, I'd hate to have to break your nose with this.
A girl with long dark hair came in here about 20 minutes ago. Do you know where she is?
What do you want?
Just do as I say, okay?
All right. Well, she was in the changing booth.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Hey, what's going on in there? Now, let's see how much your father thinks you're worth.
Yep.
Hello, Curtis.
This is an old friend. Somebody here wants to talk to you.
Dad, it's me.
Look, I'm all right.
I'm in a motel.
That's enough. Curtis, you've got a beautiful daughter. 50,000, and she stays that way.
Look, I don't know who you are, but you obviously haven't been in the business for long.
3 miles past Hillsville, there's a turnoff. Miller's Road. It goes down to an old quarry. Go there tomorrow morning. Just you and the money. And she'll be waiting for you.
You harm her and you're a dead man, I promise you.
Tomorrow morning. Alone.
You stupid bastard.
What's going on? We've been ready for this job for a month.
It'll keep.
What's the problem?
Someone's kidnapped Curtis's daughter.
Yeah?
He's taken charge.
What's he going to do?
We're going to pay the ransom.
Yeah, I bet.
Dan, look, you stay here and look after the house, huh?
Yeah, fine.
Get your sleep. We can nearly start in the morning.
Do you really think my father's going to pay you that money?
Well, he won't get you back if he doesn't.
You obviously don't know my father. He'll kill you, you know.
Perhaps he will.
Please. Let me go.
Look, I've told you, you won't get hurt. I promise.
It's me I'm worried about.
Freeze. Drop it.
Pete Shields. How stupid can you get?
Hello, Dan. How's business?
Pretty good until you showed up. Pete and Bryan Shields, professional bloody idiots. You haven't got a brain between the two of you. You really think you'll get away with this?
Bryan doesn't know what I'm up to.
Well, I do. I'm really looking forward to beating the shit out of you.
What makes you think you'll be around?
Ah, don't kid yourself.
You shot young Benetti at the markets a few years back, didn't you, Dan? Did it take much guts to pull the trigger?
More than you've got, mate.
What do you reckon, Dan? What's it feel like to get shot? Must all happen pretty quick, I imagine. Sorry to get you out of bed.
What's wrong? What's happened?
Nothing. Nothing's happened. Is Bryan around?
He's out driving. He'll be home for breakfast.
Good. I just came around to give you this.
Where is it?
It's a going away present.
Thanks. Listen, can't you stay for a while?
No. I've done what I came here to do. I've got to get away, now.
And you're not coming back?
Jeannie, I never stopped thinking about you. All the time I was in Sydney. I have always loved you.
How can you say that? You left me.
Jesus Christ. I left you because I loved you. We just can't be. I've got to go.
Listen to me, Pete. I want to be with you. Well, doesn't that mean anything to you anymore?
What do you want to do? You want to run off with me? Ditch Bryan?
I can't do that.
Well, 5 years ago, neither could I.
Come on. It's time to go.
Haven't you forgotten something?
Thank you. Do you love your daddy?
Yeah. Where are we going?
Home, darling. We're going home.